Good morning, everyone. Let us start this session. So during the last lecture, we have seen the projection of the hexagonal pyramid when the pyramid was resting on one of its base edge on the HP and it is cut by the auxiliary inclined plane. Okay. So this is the three-dimensional position. So in the first stage, we will assume the complete base of that hexagonal pyramid is resting on the HP. And axis of that pyramid is perpendicular to HP. Okay. So you can observe in the second image. So this is the first stage. In the second stage, you will rotate that front view in such a way that the axis, it will be inclined with the horizontal plane by 30 degree. Okay. And then show the position of the sectional plane. So we have completed the front view, then sectional top view and sectional side view. So this is the projection. So this is the first stage. So in the first stage, just assume the complete pyramid is resting on the HP, axis perpendicular to HP. Okay, so in the top view, you can observe this hexagon. Then complete this front view, that will be a triangle. Now rotate this front view so that angle, it will be 30 degree for the axis. And then show the position of this sectional plane. So this line, it will represent the sectional plane in the front view. Now take the projection in the top view. So initially, when you draw the top view for the second stage, do not consider the sectional plane. So just draw the normal top view and then project these intersection points. So this point 1, 2, point 3, 4, point 5 and 6, and then draw the sectional top view. Okay. And for the side view, you can draw this 45 degree line in the fourth quadrant because the side view which is visible for the section, it is from the left side. So you can observe this three-dimensional image. So from the left side, you can observe the sectional view. And therefore, we have to draw the left-hand side view. That will be on the right side of the front view in the first angle projection method. So draw this 45 degree line, take the projection from the top view and similarly take the projection from the front view and then complete this side view. Okay. So I have explained this with the help of the CAD software, that is AutoCAD. So now I will explain how to draw this by using manual drafting. So to start the projection, you should draw the XY line. Now first, start from the top view. So in the top view, you can observe the hexagon. So the base side for that hexagon, this is given as a 20 mm. So to complete the hexagon, you can use the circle method. Okay, so in this way, you can complete the top view, that is hexagon, and then show the slant edges. So we have to connect the corner of that hexagon in the top view. Now take the projection in the front view, that is on the vertical plane. Now on the axis, so this line represents the axis. So take the height of that axis. So that is 60 mm. So you can give the name to these points by referring the top view. Now this is your first stage. So you can give the dimensions. Now in the second stage, we will rotate this front view, that is make axis incline at 30 degree. So you can select any one point on this line and draw one line at 60 degree angle. So this line, it will represent the base. So draw one reference line. Now on this line, you should mark this base, which is a dash D dash. So take this distance in compass. And then draw the axis line perpendicular to this baseline. So in this second stage, first draw the projection by using continuous thin lines. So this is the center point. Now use the protractor and take the angle 90 degree. So now this line, it will represent the axis, which is 30 degree. Now complete the remaining front view as it is, similar to the first stage front view. So you can take this axis height. So draw this front view and top view in the second stage by continuous thin lines. So initially, do not consider the section plane. So just draw a front view and top view. Now take the projection from the first edge top view and find out the intersection points. So to draw this parallel lines and vertical lines, you should use the mini drafter. Or if you don't have the mini drafter, then you can use the roll and draw, that is a roller scale. Now just observe the intersection for the projectors and locate the intersection points. Now try to observe from top view. So this is the position of observer, and then decide the visible lines and the hidden lines. So this arrow will represent the position of observer. So this AB, then AF and BC, these are visible lines. Then this slant edge OC and OF, it will be visible. Then again slant edge OA and OB, it will be visible. So two slant edges, one is OE and OD, it will be hidden in the top view. And three edges of the base, one is EF, ED, and third is DC. These are hidden edges. So this projection or this top view is drawn without considering the section. So actually this line is hidden. So I have just drawn it as a continuous thin line, that is OE and OD. Now next is we have to draw the position of the section plane. So section plane is passing from a point which is 10 mm from the base. So just locate that point 10 mm from the base. So this is the point on the axis. So through this point, section plane will pass. Now at point M, draw one reference line. So that we can draw the line at an angle 60 degree. So you can use the protractor and this angle is 60 degree with respect to XY line and then draw the section plane. So section line is drawn as a long chain line having the thick ends. So you can refer the line types. So here, the portion which is above the section line or on the left side of the section line, it is to be removed. Okay. And for the remaining portion, which is to be retained, we will draw the top view and the sectional side view. Now the portion which is to be retained, show this by the continuous thick line. So this is the portion which is to be retained. So this is the front view. So left side section, which is shown by continuous thin line, it is to be removed. So this is the section plane AA. So basically this AA, it represents the direction of observer for the true shape. So if you observe exactly in perpendicular direction, then you can observe the true shape. Now mark the intersection point of this section plane with the slant edges. So first is this section plane, it will intersect the slant edge OA and OB. So we will get 2 points here, 1 and 2. Then on the slant edge OF and OC, again we will get 2 points. So 1 is 3 and 4. And on the base edges, which is EF, now project these points in the top view. So this 1 and 2 point, it is on the slant edge OA and OB. So in the top view, because I have made a mistake here, this is not point 1. So point 1, it is on the edge OA. Okay, so this is the correct position, 1 and 2. Then for 3 and 4, so 3 and 4, it is on the edge OF and OC. So this is the OF. So this is the 0.3. And on the OC, we will get 0.4. And 5 and 6, they are on the base edges. Okay. So one base edge is EF, and second is the DC. So actually, these are hidden edges in the top view. So this point is 5 and this is 0.6. Okay, now to draw this sectional top view, you should connect all these points by a straight line.
So connect 1, 2 by a straight line. Then 1, 3. This 2, 4. Then 4, 6. And 3, 5. Last 6 and 5. Okay. So the portion or lines which are shown by the continuous thick line. So this portion is to be written in the top view. So therefore, when you draw the front view and top view, initially draw this front view and top view by continuous thin lines. Okay. And after section plane, the portion which is to be written. So highlight this portion by continuous thick line. So this is the sectional top view. Now show the hatching in this region. So this is the top view of the section. So hatching lines, you can draw this hatching line at 45 degree. So I have drawn one reference line. So this is not actual geometry. So by using roller scale, you can draw all the parallel lines. So this is the use of roller scale. You can easily draw the parallel lines. Okay, so this is your complete sectional top view. Now for the side view, draw x1, y1 vertical line. Now here in the fourth quadrant, you draw one 45 degree line. Now take the projection from the top view. So initially take the projection from complete top view. Do not consider this section. So project all the corners of the hexagonal pyramid. Now take the vertical projector. And take the projection from the front view. So find out the intersection by referring the top view and the front view. Now to complete the side view, just observe from the left side. So in the side view, you can observe this A, B, C, D, E, F. It is the hexagonal base. Okay. And this O double dash, A double dash, it is the slant edge. And O double dash, B double dash, this is also slant edge. Okay. Now project the intersection points. So one point, it is on the slant edge OA, and point two, it is on the slant edge OB. Then this three and four. So it is on OF and OC. And this five and six, they are on the base edges, which is a EF and DC. So you should connect this point 5, 6, 6, 4, 4, 2, 2, 1, 1, 3, and 3, 5 by a straight line. Okay. So this is the sectional side view. So by mistake, I have connected the point this E2, 3 directly. So actually this 5, 6 DE, it is not a sectional part. So the correct sectional side view, it is up to 0.5 and 6. Okay, now let us see how to draw the true shape of the section. So you draw one parallel line to the XY line. So basically this line, it will represent the section line, which is a AA. Now on this line, you should mark the true length of the section. That is the distance between point 1 and 5. So you can take that distance in your compass. And just mark this on the horizontal line. So this point, so this is the point 5 and 6. You can refer this front view, and this point will be point 1 and 2. Similarly, locate point 3 and 4. Now from these points, draw vertical projector lines. And take the projection from this top view, that is the top view of the section. Okay, because this width, it will remain same. Only the length of the true shape, it will change. So project point 5, 3, then 6, 4, and this point 1 and 2. Okay, so this is the correct side view. Now connect all these points by a straight line. So this is the true shape of the section. And you can draw the hatching lines. So this is how you should draw the projection in the manual drafting.